Understanding why we worship helps us understand the way we worship. Worship is a personal thing, but it's also done in community. Let's look at what John says about this in John 17, verses 20 to 23. Jesus is praying to the Father specifically about those who follow him. My prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one, Father, just as you are in me and I am in you. May they also be in us so that the world may believe that you have sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave me, that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, so that they may be brought to complete unity. Then the world will know that you sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. Jesus is praying that the people of God would be unified. One way we are unified is through our doctrines. In this course, we have been focusing on our second and third doctrines. Our second doctrine says we believe that there is only one God who is infinitely perfect, the creator, preserver, and governor of all things, and who is the only proper object of religious worship. Our third doctrine says we believe that there are three persons in the Godhead, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, undivided in essence and co-equal in power and glory. In other words, there is only one true God. He is revealed in three persons, sometimes called the Trinity. This triune God is the only God to be worshiped. One way we show the world our unity is when we come together to worship God in community. However, what the world really cares about is how we live in the world outside the doors of the churches. Our unity in the world is what matters most. They will know we are Christians by our love, not only for each other, but for those outside of the church. The primary reason we worship God is because he is worthy of our worship. One reason we worship in community is to show the world our unity and point them to God. But another reason we worship in community is to learn the right example to follow. Let's look at another passage that John wrote. This time, we'll look at one of his letters, 3 John, verse 11. Dear friend, do not imitate what is evil, but what is good. Anyone who does what is good is from God. Anyone who does what is evil has not seen God. We come together for worship to focus on God, to show unity, and to learn what is good so we can imitate it in our lives outside of our church community. But this doesn't just happen. It takes planning. Planning a worship service can be really intimidating. But if you keep three things in mind, much of the rest will fall into place. First, keep the Holy Spirit in the plan from the beginning. Don't just ask God to bless the plans after you've made them. Start with prayer. Continue in an attitude of prayer. Be open and follow the Holy Spirit's leading, and end with prayer. Second, know the congregation. The most carefully and beautifully planned program can go wrong if it's for the wrong congregation. A program full of quiet, reflective moments, meditative music, and a detailed verse-by-verse sermon is wonderful for a congregation of adults who have been Christians for a long time. It would be a disaster for one with a lot of young children who stay in the meeting. Equally, A program full of puppets and action songs, visual aids, and an interactive object lesson for the sermon would be great for a choir with a lot of youth, but not for one with mostly older adults. Third, a worship service might include vocal and instrumental music, drama, or dance, but it is not a performance opportunity. All elements focus on the congregation's heart and minds on God, not on the talent of the individual or the group. The main purpose is always worship. The main focus is God. There can be a variety of elements in a program, but there are four key elements in Salvation Army worship services: prayer, scripture, a sermon, and music. Some resources that can help you plan a worship service that is centered on a specific theme or character trait of God include a Bible with a concordance, a topical Bible, and a Salvation Army songbook. Having a focus can help people draw near to God in a specific and meaningful way. Additional elements in a worship service might include a testimony, drama, dance, timbrels, children's objects, lessons, and more. Sometimes programs get to be too full. Be sure whoever is preaching has enough time. Also, leave time for a reflection and response. How we plan worship, including the songs we sing, the scripture we read, and the prayers we pray, helps draw people into a real time of communion with God. The songs chosen, for example, may help people focus on God, but we can't determine the heart. It's the Holy Spirit's job to work on each person in the worship service.